I think it's time to get started. So let's go ahead and raise the curtain and welcome back Mr. Brad Marks.
Hello, everybody. You think you got a head for heights? Be careful, baby, might fall. You think you know all your rights? You're at someone's beck and call. You think you got not a place? It's harder to eat than to play. You're in the race, you got a place. Oh, that's what they all say. You wanna stand in the working man's shoes and have someone step on your head. You wanna bruise your skin on my teeth, but you just bite me instead. You wanna come down and check out my level, something stands in your way. You're in the race, you've got a place, but that's what they all say. Standing in the rain, you don't remember my name. But baby, this ain't no place to fight. It ain't the street, it's the gutter you gotta play. We'll try that, thank you. Been through more than enough. Doctors stare things pain and other stuff. But though I try to be your solid rock, you can't count minutes on a bouldering clock. So come on out, stop crying about the rain. Stop crying about the rain. It's just water on your window pane. Hey girl, stop crying about the rain. Help if it's coming down. It's not a metaphor, just soggy ground. One drop in the bucket seems to fill your head. But just one drop is just one drop. That's what I said. So come on out, stop crying about the rain. Stop crying about the rain. Water on your window pane. Hey now, stop crying about the rain. Whoa, stop crying about the rain. Stop, 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 stop your crying. Whoa, stop, 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 stop your crying. Oh, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, you're back. Yes, thank you. God, you're a funny crowd tonight. Come on, a bit of warmth here. Stop! Enough! Oh, no. Enough. Now, yeah, what a great thing to be back. I did some touring last year, but was playing in a variety of different places, not here, and it's great to be back and see it up and running. Oh yeah, well done everybody. And I know what happened here. This label called Iconoclastic Records, a reissue label to be precise, hit me up some months back and said we'd like to license another great area. Reissue it, all tarted up with some spare tracks and some live tracks and a remastering job and nice package interviews. So I said, yep, well, fine by me. Sony owns it, so I don't give a shit. You know, what does it mean to me? Nothing. Well, I wrote the song, so there's a bit of publishing, but I'll never pay those people back ever. Arista, BMG, now Sony owns it, whatever. Anyway, c'est la vie, but so they've done that, and it's out. It's out now, and Iconoclastic Records, and but then I realized, oh, God, no. Nah, more work to do. the humanity. I got to do a couple of numbers from it. It's 40 years.
Yeah, do that. Yeah.
That was one thing I did not believe. 40 years? You must be kidding. That's not right. Very sad about that. But anyway, I have some copies of it. They sent through. Whether I have the nerve to actually listen to it or not, I don't know. But I'll leave that to you. It's 40 years old after all, whatever. But the songs, I know some of those are pretty good. And I decided to make the work even worse. I'll put this song into a different key altogether just to make it really aggravating for myself. But I quite like this version of it, and it is, in fact, from another grey area, track one, side one. Thank you. have to do your best to come up to par. Come straight out the production line like a car. Till everything you put on is a put on. And we don't know a space you're gazing upon. It could be anyone you're sending out there tonight. It isn't any wonder all the lights are too bright. And you need temporary beauty. And hope to God that it doesn't.
Suburbs
wearing band clothes. I'm a chewing hot dogs, keeping a clean nose. My best friend's a hillbilly with a moonshine still. Actually, I'm lying, he's an accountant named Bill. I don't know why you love me, baby. I don't know why you care. Socks and sandals, that's what I wear. Socks and sandals. Cause I hold on to your love hand. I'm on my mantle, fishing a pond. Oh, one of them's a fantail. Oh, one of those clocks with the rays like the sun. I eat my dinner, raincoat on. I don't know why you love me, baby. I don't know why you care. Socks and sandals, that's what I wear. Socks and sandals, cause I grip on to your love hand. You know the big-eyed one, you see her everywhere, cooking sherry and a velveteen chair in the evening. I sit by in bed. I don't know why you love me, baby. I don't know why you care. Socks and sandals, oh, that's what I wear. Socks and sandals, cause I hold on to your love handle. Well, one thing I can tell you, baby, one thing that I know. Socks and sandals ain't rock and roll. Socks and sandals, socks and sandals, socks and sandals. Sats and sandals. Oh. Day of spring has been and gone, not that you'd know it. Cold as a witch's tit out there, isn't it, really? Anyway, so let's hope that it'll go straight to 100 degrees in like a few days. That's what's going to happen, isn't it? Yeah, summer, we'll be complaining again. Anyway, this song, First Day of Spring, I am going to do it anyway. Up above, but it is not as blue as love. The stars might shine brightly in the night, but that is not the only light. No, that is not the only light illuminating us tonight. Come out of the bitter wind. First day of spring, the world might looks smaller from the sky, but the beauty of it makes me cry. Ocean is deeper than my tears, but it is not a thing to fear. No, it is not a thing to fear. It's all the tides turning, dear. Come out of the bitter wind. Melt that ice deep within on the first day of spring. First day of spring. The sky might be massive up above, but it is not as blue as love. The rain might fall down on us, but hey, that is not the deepest grave. No, that is not the deepest grave. Hanging over us today, come out of the bitter wind. Tomorrow is bound. First day of spring. The first day of spring. First day of spring. First day of spring. Winter Olympics, I must say, and I watched that when it was on not too far back, and I noticed they were talking a lot about the snow wasn't really in great abundance there, so they had the snow guns blasting away with that phony snow that looks like cake mix down below, as I say in the song. So I thought, let's sing that song. That snow gun blasts into the future from the past. It blasts that phony snow that looks like cake mix down below. From my vantage here upon this mountain steep chair, I can see a lot, but it's not always crystal clear. A lot of turns, and one of them just made me pay. So I always knew the strong winds would come around and take you away. So I check my gear and make sure everything is strapped on tight, because I've seen a lot of accidents. That's why I'll be alone tonight. I'm on Belly Mountain. The snowgun blasts on my own. High on Billy Mountain, where the snowgun blasts on my own. Crystals block my vision, and it's hard to keep the trail in sight. But just like snowflakes, no two words are quite alike. So I check my gear and make sure everything is strapped on tight, 'cause seen a lot of accidents. That's why I be alone tonight. That's what they all say, which came from the album Heat Treatment.
Yeah.
1976, second album. And here's another one from that one, from that record. When you get inside my head, it just goes empty. With all that junk I've been fed, you think I'd let you get me? Hey baby, what are you blind? How long have you been? Someday so out of date. Now I can say your love is turned up too late. Studio album out and 2018 I believe, but hope to rectify that later in the year and get one done.
Yeah,
there's been a bit of disruption here and there, haven't there? You know, that's right. It hasn't felt like a good time to really be going into a studio with a bunch of people breathing all over each other, but time will come. And I've actually already been in and recorded a couple of tracks that will be out soon digitally. Different story from an album later on, which might be 2023, we'll see. And I'll tell you more about that in a few moments. But this one is from the last studio album, Cloud Symbols, for the ladies, I believe. When you say you're weary, you sound like a girl in need. When you say you're teary-eyed, just let it water recede. When you think you're past your prime, reinvent yourself one more time. I hit the road with a bag of nails, build a house that withstands the gales and storms. Whoa. But it wasn't that bad at all. 'Cause when the light came shining through, oh, what a wake-up call. I was floating in the amniotic, all too easy, so narcotic. I once knew a girl who was quite erotic, but she was vacant like an empty pocket. But yourself will. But you're missing. You'll find out that it's nothing like a kiss. More like something to cross off your list. For a girl in need has a list so long, no one can find the time to read it. Has she ever thought she really might not need it? Your prime, reinvent yourself one more time. Hit the road with a bag of nails, build a house that withstands the gales and storms. Oh yeah. Well, a girl in need is an everyday sight. Hold her hand and then you make it bite. Give her a light that shines at night. Don't be a scumbag, hold it tight. Girl in need. Whoa, oh, yeah. She's a girl in need. Yeah. Oh, girl in need.
Thank you.
Yes.
Right, okay, yes, sorry about this.
very sorry. Apologize. A kazoo is on stage. You know it's someone who is going downhill rapidly. Desperate. Desperate for attention. This song really needs a kazoo. It needs something. I don't know whether I've been here and told you this story about the kazoo. It's sort of a quasi-religion, really, kazoos. Not many people know, there's a little known branch of Buddhism that uses the kazoo. It works, it's a sort of a combo thing, Buddhism, kazoo, because I'm not really sure what it's something to do with the it sort of gets you off quicker, you know. That's like taking fast-acting edibles, you know, they kick in 10 minutes instead of waiting for an hour plus, you know. You can get them, they're good, actually, really good. 10 minutes, and it's like, yeah, okay. Chill. Unless you overdose, then you're sitting on the couch going, it's just a drug, it'll wear off, it's just a drug. Watch your edibles, people. Now, yes, what was I saying? I'm lost. Oh, yeah, it's the edible kicking in. No, that wouldn't be very good at all. Now, this song, lockdown, right? First lockdown, 2020. Let me take my shades off. I can't see. Okay, two guys in the front, right? That's it. There's a lady there. Oh, my goodness, and a chat next to her, yeah. Okay, a lady. Right. You're probably people I know by the first name, but I cannot quite. Oh, yes. There you go. I'm starting to pick them up now. Yes, why I wear shades of it. What just happened? Oh, let me have a look. Oh, look, it's the young crowd here tonight. Wow. Very good, yes. The young crowd is here. Right, now. All right, back to normal. Now. Lockdown 2020, I was in London at the time. I happened to be stuck there. I knew there'd be no gigs in that particular year, but I did get to America in June, and it was a lot easier than 2021 when they really didn't want anyone to come in, frankly. But the planes were great, empty planes, wonderful, beautiful. Anywho, I certainly didn't have to upgrade from Economy Plus or whatever I was in. Did not need to. Now, I was, of course, you know, I thought, okay, this is great. Don't have to do jack shit. Lockdown, nothing. This is great, man. Okay, the guitar stayed on the stand, glaring at me. Do something. It said, dude. I said, fuck off. No, I'm not going to. Don't want to. I've written enough songs. Thanks. Bugger off. So the guitar sitting there glaring. But of course, I picked it up, and that's what I do, isn't it? I write songs and muck around on guitar. So I did get a couple of songs started, but I couldn't. Couldn't really pull the trigger on them because, as I say, you know, you couldn't go into a studio with a bunch of people with any safety, and I wasn't going to do all that remote thing. So I had these songs, and I did sort of do a FaceTime with my kids who were in America at the time, and played them a bit of one of the songs, but that's the next one, which is deeply offensive. I'll do that one on the first encore, okay? There's two songs, okay? Soon to come out on a digital single, so it's worldwide, you can get on Spotify and rip me off royally, don't care anymore, it doesn't matter. There's no hope, record sales are, you know, gone with the dinosaurs for most of us, but digital is there, so at least you can hear something now again, if you wish, and maybe it'll be printed into a single later on. It's two tracks, and the first track, well, anyway, lockdown, back to that, I had a marvellous time, the sun was out in Britain, it turned out, to be the sunniest spring on record, I think, and it was marvellous. You know, no cars, the air was fresh. I live in a beautiful part of London, there's all these canals. When I'm not here, I'm back and forth. But, and the canals, you could see the bottom of the canals because the boat traffic wasn't on them. Beautiful patina of plastic bags on the bottom of the, of the canal. Oh, it was attractive, you know. Well, of course, I was out of my head every day. That's looking pretty good. Look at the colours of those bags. Yes, it was wonderful. I'd walk around. I'd go down to the local pub, And of course, the pub wasn't open, so if they can't bring you the beer, I'll take the beer to them. It's just a walk. Down the road I go, pint of beer in a plastic glass. All right, mate. You can do that in England anyway, but there were no cops around to ask me where I was going, because you were only supposed to go out and exercise and run into shops and run out again. So I'd go down to the local pub, beautiful pub, sit on the marble steps, overlooking this big roundabout there, traffic circle to you. Big thing, all covered in foliage. It was beautiful. Invariably, a few mates would turn up. They'd bring beer as well. Yeah, and beer, alcohol wasn't the only drug involved. Powders came out, things like that. So, okay, party! Here we go. Nobody came along to tell us to move on. No cops, no nothing. It was great. Oh man, can this go on for a couple of years as well? So yeah, my wishful thinking about doing nothing for the rest of my life, I'm sorry about that, because that's I tend to affect the universe, and I've really messed you all up for a long time, and a long time ago, I'm sorry. But anyway, I did enjoy myself. I thought, great, God, do nothing forever, be careful what you wish for. But here's one of the songs, and it's the song I'm going to do for the first encore, which is the kind of A-side of this double sort of alleged single that will be coming out very soon. This song, however, is not really, yeah, I guess it's offensive, but it's more sick, really. It's more creepy. It's the product of a diseased mind, quite frankly. But it made me laugh fit to beat the band. It really did when I wrote it. I thought, that's great, that'll show them. So let me, so here we go, and if this kazoo will stay on time. Yes, the kazoo, I learned a kazoo from, there's a lot of things people don't know. There's a little known enclave where they, you go to a sort of monk. His name is Feng Shui, actually. He became my master. Learning the kazoo. It took me about 6 months because I wanted to be a kazoo master. I don't like to go halfway when it comes to playing instruments. And it was brutal. It was brutal. But it's a little known enclave. Actually, in Trenton, New Jersey. There's a lot of very culty things going on there. You have to look very hard to find them. But I found the kazoo master and the whole. Everyone living in mud huts and shit like that, and you'd get up at 4 a.m. and you'd chant and say prayers and things to the kazoo god or whatever it was. And then you'd practice kazoo. And he would come to me, at about noon every day and say, "Grasshopper, play kazoo." So I'd play. And he said, no, grasshopper, no. Always with a little humor. I said, "It's a fucking kazoo, it's funny, just looking at it, what are you talking about?" He said, no, bring internal humour to add to humour of kazoo. I thought, bloody hell, are we laughing too much or feeling sick? What are you talking about, mate? Anyway, I passed, I became a kazoo master, and, and I have this trouble ever since with these, you have to put rubber bands about. I'm sorry, I'm going on here, I'll shut up right now and hopefully get this really deeply creepy song to you. Gonna get me a 3D printer and make a copy of you. Plastic filaments, coated eyeballs. It sounds creepy, I know. But in this endless lockdown, I will. Seems years away. I've seen the fly. What a scary movie. Well, that might ruin your day. In this endless lockdown, I'll try anything. A Stepford wife is worth a shot. Now why is that? Why is that such a sin? Because it is. Order now, lockdown prices, 3D printer. questions. That's pretty sick. Anyway, well. Thank you very much for putting up with it. That kazoo was not funny. That was pathos, I thought. I had a lot of pathos in it. And now we're going to 1977, which I didn't have much pathos in. No, I was quite wicked. New York Shuffle. Baby with a sing-song voice, got a place in the human zoo. Went to live down on the boulevard now that the revolution's due. She said, I've been around from town to town, learned to love and hate. Time don't change nothing, you and me, baby. You get hurt, it's through that gate. And do the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle, learn to stay awake all night. Yeah, the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle, get yourself uptight, yeah. Get uptight. Now stick around, kid, you're gonna see some action shooting in the streets. Grab a gun before the police come. Don't tell me you're too sweet. Cause down in the alley they're hitting hard. I'm as stoned as a log can be. They're burning flags here, dressed in drag here. Sure as a sight to see. And do the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle. Learn to stay awake all night. In the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle, get yourself uptight. Hey! I'm Mr. Mayor, give me the key, let me lock you up. Slow that key down the deepest subway in New York. New York. Electric dream, bang my head against the ground. I got to get out quick before I get as sick as the people living in this town. Bounce me off the pavement, bounce me off the wall, bounce me off the taxi cars. Oh, give me a shot of that old Jack Daniel, put me behind bars. Now do the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle, learn to stay awake all night. Yeah, the New York Shuffle, New York Scuffle, get yourself uptight, yeah. Get uptight down in New York City. Get uptight down in New York, baby. Another grey area reissue. Here's one from that record. You hit the spot, send a heat wave through my brain. Another shot of an antidote to pain. When I get the fear, gets down to the bone. But when you're near, you hit the spot, everybody makes me cringe. It's worth a shot, I'd rather burn than singe. When the walls close in and I feel crushed, I'll take your calls, I'll take your love and say, ooh baby, your love does it all. Ooh can crawl. You hit the spot, wipe out the rest of the world. Don't ask me why, you're gonna be my girl. It's a natural sign among your substitutes. This before in this venue at some point, maybe a few times, and I would have told you the story about it because it needs telling. Let's say Florida isn't exactly my biggest market. It never has been, I don't think I'm alone in that probably. It was somewhere around the late 90s, I guess. I don't know, it must have been around there, late 90s, because this came out on Deep Cuts of Nowhere, which I remember as being 2001. My agent said, look, there's a couple of venues in Florida I want you, one in St. Petersburg and one in Orlando, fly in there, and one's on a Friday night, one's on a Saturday. So, I thought, well, I got a gap there and whatever I was doing, so yeah, okay, I'll take on a couple of gigs in Florida and fly in there, rent a car and do the thing on my own, no problema. See what happens. And just before I went, a few weeks before, I said, wait a minute, there's a gig come up on Saturday, it's an offer, because you've got the Friday, you've got the Sunday and the Saturday off, which makes no sense. So I said, all right, where is it? He said, Jacksonville. Okay, never, whatever. What do I know? It's Florida. It's all the same anyway. Right? I don't know nothing about Florida much. So yeah. Okay, put it in. He said the money's crap. But, it's a Saturday night.
60
it's sort
bucks.
Of agent talk. Agent talk now. What did you say, sorry?
60 bucks.
For me, for a wealthy person, yes, it might as well have been 60 bucks. No, anyway. It was not enough, thank you. But I said, I don't care, get a hotel, at least I've a couple of bucks coming, whatever, instead of sitting around in Florida. So yeah, I said, I'll take the gig. So Friday in St. Petersburg, I fly in, I get there, I'm expecting the sunshine to say, it's torrential rain, it's like the monsoons, it's bloody awful. I get out of the plane, rental car's right there, I'm sloshing through the parking lot, the water up to my ankles. get in there, get my rental car. I said, I've just got to go to the hotel, I want to check in, then I've got a gig in St. Peter's. It's across that bridge there. He said, oh yeah, the bridge is closed. I'm like, well, how am I going to get there? He said, oh, you can't get there. I'm like, no, the gig must happen, mate. I must. I've got to check in my hotel first, dump some stuff off, and get the sound check in the afternoon. So, I drove out of the parking lot and I looked at the bridge, no one's blocking it, no barricades. I drove over the bastard, found my hotel, went in there, told him my name, oh great to see you, blah blah blah. Gave me my key, which was one of the few first times I think I'd seen one of those key, electronic keypad thing. And they said, yeah, here's your key, but you can't get in because there's no power. So, okay, thank you, this is looking good, Florida. We shouldn't have come here. I knew it. Anyway, went to the gig, went to the venue, old theatre, St. Petersburg. Sat down in a room, the dressing room, old-fashioned theatre building, small dressing room this size, you know. Rain is coming through in various spots. I had to place my guitars very, you know, exactly in the right spots. And I, you know, so I did the sound check and sat there for a couple of hours like this. What's going on? Oh, you know, the humanity of it all, this is horrific. So I just did that. Went out, the audience wasn't too bad. It wasn't too shabby. It was, you know, good enough for me in Florida. And so I had that gig, and then next day, driving out to Jacksonville. Now, when I arrived in Florida, I read a paper or something, and or heard it on the radio. Some girl about 14 years old, a terrible thing, was a culvert in St. Peter, around St. Petersburg area, and sit playing there, and all this rain had been building up, and whatever, further upstream from this little ditch, she was mucking around, and suddenly this deluge of water came down and pushed her into the culvert, into the, you know, one of those things, tubes in the ground, and she died, and it was a horrible thing. I thought, my God, this place, who lives in Florida? And it was a sickening thing, you know, for any parent or whatever. And next day I drove up to Jacksonville. Rain is coming off the overpasses like a biblical proportions of rain. I'm driving, oh, Christ, white knuckles a whole bit, you know. And managed to get up to Jacksonville. And there I read about a 21-year-old woman who was not exactly, you know, adult here in this part of the body, in her brain. And she liked to play with little kids often, you know. She was down by another sort of drain runoff thing, and there was some concrete. The kids, little kids, got out of the way, but this torrential load of water came down. She got dragged into the tunnel and came out 11 blocks later, alive. Absolutely alive. It was in the papers, and I, you know, I didn't even imagine it, because somebody from St. Petersburg got hold of me years later, like a decade later, and said, I'm listening to your song. Did this really happen? And, you know, I said, well, this thing with the girls did, unless I dreamed it just to write a song. So that kind of guy. He looked it up. It did. It happened. I got it pretty much right, I'll tell you what. Anyway, I went to the Milk Bar. That was the name of the place I was playing in, certainly Jacksonville. I mean, yeah, Milk Bar, doesn't that say it all? So I go down and say, there's a band there, a young band. He's obviously, the promoter has got them so that they can put them on for free with an international name so that they can lend me the amplifier, because in my contract it says amplifier to be provided. Now, this promoter was not going to pay for an amplifier, so I got this young band in place. I know how this works. I know how it all works. So I did my sound check and said, okay guys, have a good gig. Went to my dressing room, which is even smaller than the one in St. Petersburg. It was basically a velvet curtain, like a triangle in the corner. Okay, got about 3 hours here. I'll just stand like this and show. But after the band, unbeknownst to me, there was another act on, a solo act. Oh, for God's sake, why do they bother with this crap? It was a local guy, I presume. And this guy, I mean, this was mad. He was bald, you know, he wasn't older, and he was bald. Head like the size of a watermelon. It was like somebody had put a pump in it and blown it up. I swear, did they find these people? Now, by now, there's 30 people in the audience. I'm thinking, but Jacksonville, that's probably amazing, great. I thought it was probably amazing because, you know, who am I there? And, anyway, he starts playing. I swear, every song, every single song sounded the same. It was like an unholy cross between Neil Young and Johnny Rotten. I promise you. It was like... Algeria, gonna set it, tell you, gonna stick it to the wall. I'm gonna fuck it, get it, get it. Man should be in a straitjacket. The audience, however, are applauding heartily. They think this is good. So I thought, well, they're going to love me. Well, basically, here's some real music, not this nutcase. So anyway, he goes away, disappears. I go up there, do my show. The audience are still sitting there, same amount of people. Okay, let's go. Play the song first. First song goes out. The applause is tepid. That's the only way I can describe it. It's like, oh, okay. All right, I'm not going to speak to these people at all. I'm not going to be polite. I'm just going to play my set and get the bugger out of here. So I start playing a second song, and now a few people drift off. It's getting thinner. Next song, a few more people drift off. Only later did I think, this might have been orchestrated by the melon head. That's what was going on here. This guy brought all his friends down, who are equally fucking bonkers, I'm sure, like him, they must be. And he said, yeah, just walk out, one more. So they did. I mean, I just wanted to get that melon head and smash the melon head. But anyway, I may be imagining that, but I don't think so. So anyway, there it was, and I'm left with two couples. Gotta go there, gotta go there. Right, oh, that's it. They are fans, they're digging it, they're singing along with Start a Fire, or whatever it was. And then suddenly, out of the gloaming, there's this other guy. He walks out from nowhere. I thought, who's this guy? Fuzzy-haired guy, obviously another mental case. Obviously, I mean, you didn't see it. Well, oh, it's Jacksonville. He walks up to one of the women, the couples, and looks at her legs like this. He stares at her legs, because they're sitting right near the front. Then he walks off, disappears into the gloaming. Comes back, does it again. I'm like, oh God, this is entertaining. I'm sorry. He comes back and does it for a third time. Like that, right at her leg. You know, sort of a little. The guy couldn't take it any longer. A boyfriend, husband, wife. He gets up, grabs this guy, this nutter by the lapels, and headbutts him. True story. Five people I've got in my audience, and there's a fight. This is my life. This is it. It's all detailed in this song, the horror of all of this. Oh, I'm feeling a bit weak just thinking about it, sorry. All right, but I wrote a song about it. Oh, the other thing was the two guys who were running the bar, of course, the manager never set foot near the place. No, of course he didn't. They were like, you know, they leapt over the pool table to break up the fight, and so the couple stayed and the nutter got thrown out. But they were playing pool over here. You could hear the balls clicking while they were playing the set. Yeah, they were nice enough guys. But, you know, they had that. They had the Ted Nugent. What's the joke? There's a Leonard Skinner joke. But we call it that. What has 40 hands and 3 teeth? The front row of a Ted Nugent concert. Was one of those. So they came over, these boys. And later on, they were very nice. They introduced me to Jägermeister. That was fun. As detailed in the song. Here he goes. Two young girls are strapped down, the culverts in the rain. St. Petersburg was flooded again. I reached my hand out for them, but I watched them slip away. And I had to get up to Jacksonville that day. I don't need anyone to remind me, I don't get the big picture. I don't need anybody to find me, hanging from a lighting fixture. Play Jacksonville again. I'll never get on that southbound airplane. They gave me a ticket, pointed me south, gave me $500 to shut my mouth. I'll never play Jacksonville. I'll never have that weird thrill. I'll never play Jacksonville again. Again.
like a river. The fields were like the sea. The thunder clouds were closing in on me. I gunned that motor onwards at Route I-95. Checked my pulse. Yep, still alive. I don't need anyone to remind me to take my hand out of the fire. I don't need anybody to find me tied up in piano or wire. Hey, I'll never play Jacksonville again. I'll never get on that southbound airplane. They gave me a ticket, pointed me south. Gave me $500 and said, shut your mouth, boy. I'll never play Jacksonville. I'll never have that with thrill. I'll never play Jacksonville again. Again. Put you on at the milk bar. I said, hey, good luck, kid. Here's your Jägermeister. Here's half a lid. Put the pass behind you. It's over, pay your bill. This is where it ends now. Jacksonville. I don't need anyone to remind me. I'm on the end of the skewer. I don't need anybody to find me floating around in the sewer. Hey, I'll never play Jacksonville again. I'll never get on that southbound airplane. They gave me a ticket, pointed me south, gave me $500 to shut my mouth. I'll never play Jacksonville. I'll never have that strange thrill. I'll never play Jacksonville again. 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 Again.
Says I might play there again, but I haven't had any offers.
I wonder why.
I'll give you $60 you play there again.
I'll do it, man. I'll do it for that. Yeah. No money in records anymore. I'll do it. I'm here for $60. I'm anybody's for $60.
You have to open for Melonhead.
What's that?
You have to open for Melonhead.
Yeah, I will seek him out. I will seek him. I'm sure he's probably big in Florida by now.
Literally.
Yes. Anyway, stick to me. How about that? Every last drop will go into this now. I don't wanna miss now. I don't know where to stop. I just pump and pump till that's all it is. Stick to me, just like a rule now. Stick to me, that's what to do now. Race against time. What I'm into, pay now and get through on the hotline. People's voices screaming the choices. You better stick to me, just like a lunar. Stick to me, that's what to do stick to me while the vampires bite on their teeth. Come down. If you stick to me, I'll be singing sweet. We won't drown. We won't drown. We won't drown. Yeah, and I've seen it happen. People cracking under the weather, buried beneath the rooftops, the weight of the sky coming down on them. You're gonna stick to me just like a lunar. Stick to me. That's what to do now. Oh yeah. If you stick to me while the white shark's back on their teeth, come down. If you stick to me on the sinking sea, we won't drown. Stick to me just like a luna. Stick to me. To do now, stick to me, stick to me, stick to me. Go back to the beginning of 1976 for the title track of my first record. The waterfall's twinkling like bells in my ears. Earth rolls out before me through smiles and tears. A country life, a soul discovered. The ruins I once was well soon to cover. Yes, a howling wind runs through here, takes my breath away. Swing time is here, children, for large and small. Let's dance before the fever comes. Upon us all. Yeah, I got a strange religion. Ain't got any God. The preacher walks within us and spares the rod. And I know that a howling wind runs through here. Oh, yeah. Swing time is here, children. For large and small. Let's dance, dance, dance till the fever comes way down, down upon us all. Yes, I know that a howling wind runs through here, blowing every single day. Sticking with the Howlin Wind record for this one too. Don't see there be no break in the line. Don't see there be no break, boys. They ruined my vision, screwed up my eyes. Tell you what I'm gonna do, boys. I'm going back to school days. I'm going back to school days. I'm going back to school days to put them right. Told me that it was like a film out here. It's a real hot show, boys. You told me that it was all black and white. So many shades of can't see, boys. I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, to put them right. And nobody wants to know you when you're down. Everybody wants to lose you when you're found. Yeah, but I think I might break even. I might go home quietly and marry a rich girl, but otherwise gonna raise hell and brightly. I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, to put them right. Shake that thing, I said. Confused, don't give it all of the blame, boys. I'm 25 years and to break the rule. No wonder I'm having the same, boys. I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, to put them right. I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, I'm gone. Back to school days, to put them right. Gonna put them right. Yeah, put them right. Gonna put them right. Gonna put them right. Yeah. Gonna put them right. Gonna put them right. Hey. Something from the Squeezing Out Sparks record.
Yeah.
A big enchilada with that, this one. It was much better than a fantasy. Imagination's one thing, comes easy to me. Cause this is nothing else, in my diary. When I pretend to touch you, you pretend to feel. Passion is so hard in the world. Passion is so hard in the world. I think I heard. Passion is so hard in the world. Ain't manufactured. are just another sound that you hear at night. At night. We got new idols for the screen today. They make a lot of noises, but they got nothing to say. I tried to look amazed, but it's an act. A moving avenue, but it's the same soundtrack. Passion is the ordinary word. I think I heard. Passion is the ordinary word. No, 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 no. Passion is the ordinary word. Hey, manufacturer, I just another sound. At night. Say how it feels, real useless, ain't it? Waiting till it bites right down inside you. The world is easy when you just playing around with it. Everything's a thrill, every girl's a kill. Then it gets unreal. You don't feel anything, anything. You don't feel anything. You don't feel anything. To be. But the shop window dumb is given just as easily. I try to stop, but I have to make it drop down to the floor. Moaning in the darkness as we fake some more. Passion is no ordinary word. I think I heard. Passion is no ordinary word. I tell you true. Passion is no ordinary word. Hey, manufactured, I just another sound that you hear at night. At night, that you hear at night. At night, that you hear at night. Not just another sound that you hear at night. Not just another sound that you hear at night. Not just another sound. That you're mine. Not just another sound that you hear tonight. Not just another sound. Not just another sound. I'm doing this song before I did this tour, but I thought, how the hell with it? This is from the Three Chords Good album, the reunion record that we made, and strangely it was on there. It was about 10 years ago, and strangely I'm going to do it again, I feel. And thank you very much. What a crowd. You've been really warm. Thank you. Thank you, John, and coming points and all who sail in her and be very well. Sorry, I gotta do this one. It's just. Let's go back to a time in prehistory. When the women walked out to the bush with a stake from a tree. When the men sat around in the sand and the mud and the sod. When they stared at the wild stars and invented God. The same dark forces operate here and now today. The reptilian brain creeps forward and comes out to play. I was on the prowl when he stripped your rights away. To send you back to a back alley, back to a darker day. Oh well, here come the wrecking crew swinging their hammers. Girls, get your coat hangers. Yeah. Come on, girls. Come on, girls. Get your coat hangers. Get your coat hangers. Ships are coming by Camelot limousine. To criminalize your body. Working through the ranks right up to the highest court. Cause being knocked up by your daddy, that's all your fault. Well, here come the judges swinging their hammers. Come on, girls, get your cold hammers. Well, come on, girls. Come on, girls. Come on, girls, get your coat cool hangers. Get your coat cool hangers. Get them. Get them. I'll get them. According to Leviticus, to Genesis, to Deuteronomy. In the world of the blind, the one-eyed man can see. On the planet of the mute, the two-eared man is free. In the halls of the king, they call that a mystery. Well, you might need a stiff drink, maybe some slammers. Come on, girls, get your cool hangers. Well, come on, girls. Come on, girls. Come on, girls, get your coat hangers. Get your coat hangers. Yeah, get them, get them, get them. Get them, get them, get them. Get them, get them, get them. Yeah, get them, get them. Get your coat hangers. I told you so. 10 years ago. Thank you very much, ladies and thank you, darling, Warren. Thank you. Oh, man. You coming with me to Staten Island tomorrow, you know? That's where they're coming. They're coming next week. I'll put them in woods tonight, don't you worry. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. Be well. Be very well. So many thanks for that. Well, now, as I told you earlier, I did that song 3D printer out at any minute, I hope, next week even, digitally, for my tiny miniature record company in England, and get their shit together and get it out. Doesn't take much, put it on digital, that's it. People will stream it and rip me off royally. Doesn't matter anymore. They win. We lose. Well, okay, we're just the people who write the songs. Doesn't really matter much. No big deal. Well, let me do the A side of this one now. That first one, as I said, was creepy, sinister, product of a diseased mind. This song is, it's a thing of great beauty. It's deeply, deeply offensive. Thank you for being offended here tonight. Thank you very much. Please take this advice as well, if you would. Millions and millions of years ago, I picked something up, I don't know, in a city diner or a takeaway. It got inside me, wouldn't go away. I'm sorry, baby, you're sorry too. I did not mean to infect you. That's not accurate, that's not true. I poison your mind, is what I do. Cause humans are the mutant virus. We are not immune. Humans are the mutant virus. The sooner we're gone, the better. Well, there are many volcanoes to choose from. Cliffs of plenty too. Many high towers to punch from. Let's do this thing, let's do it. Too much to say. Let's put this thing to rights. Yeah, it wasn't invented in a Chinese lab. It came from nature like the others have. The universe doesn't want you here. Stop begging for help. Disappear. Humans are the mutant virus. No one is immune. Humans are the mutant virus. The sooner we come, the better. Humans are the human virus. Humans are the sooner we come, the better. Humans are the mutant virus. No one is immune. Humans are the mutant virus. The sooner we come. The sooner we go, the better. Yeah, please take my advice. We're all in together. Woo! Well, travel safely. I'll be off to Staten Island. Allegedly play outdoors in someone's backyard. It's a sort of a official but house style gig. And, well, if it's this temperature, I'm not playing outside. The crowd can sit out there. I'm playing in the living room. Anyway, thank you very much. This one comes from a pink EP from 1976 or 77. Yeah. Much appreciated, people. Be well. Song by the Tramps that I cover. Don't want to dream about you, baby. Hold back the night. Turn on the light. Don't want to dream about you, baby. When you left, you took the sun right out of my sky. Yes, it is. Wonder why you went away. I never told me why. When the sun goes down, the moon is near. Scared to death cause your face appears. Hold at the night, turn on the light. Don't wanna dream about you, baby. Hold at the night, turn on the light. Don't wanna dream about you, baby. Loneliness haunting me when I go to bed. Yes, it is like a character in a book that I've never read. When the sun goes down, the moon is near. Scared to death is your face appears.
We are. Thank you, Grant, for coming out. And you, the audience, thank you for coming out.